Good afternoon, students. Today, I am going to teach computer science for class 10. Today, I have discussed about the nested looping statement, that is nested for loop, nested while loop, and nested do loop. Some questions I have discussed today. Based on nested looping statement. Some more questions I have written today. This question, number one, I have already done. I have already solved yesterday. I am going to start from the question number two. Student, what is this? This is the output which is based on the multiple rows, and multiple columns. These are the multiple columns. I told you yesterday, students, something you want to display, some calculation you want to display in the form of multiple rows and multiple columns, nested loop is required. Either nested for loop or nested while loop or nested do loop. Let us see now. I am going to write a program. Question number two, based on nested for loop. Student, here I am writing question number 2. CLS for loop for I equal to 1 to 5. Again for loop for j equal to 1 to i. Now print statement. Print I, not j. See the difference? Print I. After that, next j. Then print a statement again. Print next I and int. I have written a statement. Let us see now. I told you yesterday, this is outer for loop. This outer for loop is written for the number of rows. How many rows are there in the question number 2? There are 5 rows. So that I have written for I equal to 1 to 5. Student, other for loop. This is the inner for loop. This inner for loop we write for the number of columns. So that a student, in the first row, 1 column, second row, 2 columns, third row, 3 columns, mean columns are increasing. So that for j equal to 1 to i, let us start from the checking of the condition. Here student, 1 less than 5, yes, condition of outer for loop is true. And when the condition of outer for loop is true, it comes in the body of outer for loop. Cursor comes in the body of outer for loop, inner for loop is executed. Again, it will check the condition of inner for loop. Retain j equal to 1 to i, the 1 less than equal to i ko value ka dicha 1, so 1 equal to 1, yes condition is true. It comes in the body of inner for loop. In the body of inner for loop, print statement is written. Print what? I. Hum ye jipani print karna sakte ho, tarah se output change bhi aa jata. Print I kar liya chu, to i ko value ka dicha 1, that is printed as student. After that, semicolon is there. It means after printing 1, cursor is waiting in the same line to print the next output. This is the function of semicolon. Now, student, next j, you know very well. Next j means it increases j by 1 by default. So that j equal to j plus 1. The j ko value ka dicha 1, the 1 plus 1 equal to 2. It becomes 2 now. J becomes 2 now. It goes to check condition up. 2 less than 10? No. 2 equal to 10? No. Both conditions are false. And when the conditions are false, this inner for loop statements are not executed. Bhanno ko matlab, this print statement is not going to be executed. What will be happening? Cursor comes down at the bottom of next day. This print statement is written. This print statement is not going to print anything. It is written to bring the cursor in next row. Cursor brought in the next row. Who brought? This print statement brought the cursor in the next row. next row. Now next I equal to I plus 1. Again the value of I is 1, the 1. Again the value of I is 1, the 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Value of I becomes 2. It goes to check condition up again. I to value 1 0, that becomes 2 now. It will check the condition again. 2 less than 5. Yes, condition is true. Yes, condition is true. Yes means it comes in the body of outer for loop. In the body of outer for loop, inner for loop is there for j is equal to 1 to I. Dhyan dene Mr. Student, our inner for loop ko kisma, again it is started from 1. You very one that is shuru hunchan. 1, 1 to I to value condition 2. Now, 1 to 2, that is 1 less than 2. Yes, condition is true. Inner for loop condition is true. It comes in the body of inner for loop. This print statement executed. Print what? I. The I to value condition 2. The 2. Kaha print karsan? Karsan yahan cha, it prints 2. Now, student, ganganos, semicolon. Means after printing 2, cursor is waiting in the same line for the next print statement. Next J, J equal to J plus 1. Very sure one, J equal to J plus 1. J equal to 1, sir. 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Very J equal to 2. We are goes to test condition up again. J, of J2 we are doing. 2 equal to 2. Yes, condition is true. Again, condition is true. Again, comes in the body of inner for loop. Print statement executed, print I. The I ko value kadi cha, I ko value the 2 cha. It prints 2 at the position of cursor in the same line. Again student, semicolon means cursor is waiting in the same line, same row. Next J, J equal to J plus 1, the 2 plus 1 equal to 3. J becomes 3 now, it goes to check condition here. 3 less than 2, no. 3 equal to 2. Condition is false. And when the condition is false, same thing I told you earlier, this much statement will not be executed. Come down, this print statement executed. This print statement is not going to print anything. It is going to bring this cursor in the next row, that is third row. Last time I am executing this program, student. Next I equal to I plus 1. The value of I is 2. Value of I is 2. Now 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Now the value of I becomes 3 now. Student, you know very well. Again it goes to check condition up. I, that becomes 3. 3 less than 5. Yes, condition is true. Again comes. Again here follow, dhyan dena sir student, last time I am explaining this program. Again J equal to 1 to I, here J 1 dekhi shuru huncha. Or 1 dekhi, 1 to I, kaha samajhan chan? 3, the 1 to 3, again 1, I, that is 3, the 1 less than 3, yes condition is true. Comes in the body of inner for loop, print statement executed, print I, the I kavari kadi cha? 3, that is printed at the position of cursor. Semicolon cursor is waiting in the same line. Next J, J equal to J plus 1, the J equal to 1 cha, again 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Goes to check condition, 2 less than 3. Yes, condition is 2. Again comes print I to value early funny 3H student. That is printed in the same line, same row. Like that, here next J, the 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Again, condition will change. 3 equal to 3. Yes, condition is true. Print J. That is 3. Bujhi ra chanita? Like that, student. You have dhyan denos. Next J. The 3 plus 1 equal to 4. Our hair knows. 4 less than 3. No condition is false. 4 equal to 3. No condition is false. Both conditions are false. This much part is not executed. Print a statement to bring the cursor. Your cursor line. It brings in the fourth row. Next I equal to I plus 1, the 3 plus 1 equal to 4. Goes to check condition up. Like that student, for the fourth row, like that for the fifth row, fourth row makari, yaha 4, kati choti, 4 choti. Again, the value of I becomes 5, the 5 pani, 5 choti. Such a way, when the value of I becomes 6 now, who knows, when the value of I becomes 6, 6 less than 5?
No.
6 equal to 5?
No.
Condition of outer for loop is false. And when the condition of outer for loop is false, matlab for I dekhi next I sum of apni apni statement execute kar lena. Kone kone statement execute kar rahe because the condition of outer for loop is false. Come down in the statement executed, that is stop and terminate the program execution. What have you seen, a student? 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. This output, that is the question number 2. What have you seen? What have you seen? When you have a requirement, when you have a requirement to display the information in the form of multiple rows and multiple columns, nested for loop or nested while loop is required. Clear? Understood now? Now, अब ध्यान देने उस question number 3. अब फिर यही पूरा था, but output is different. अब सोचनो उस रब बनाऊँ उस, सोचनो उस रब बनाऊँ उस. You can solve very easily. Let us see now. Let us see now, student. लिखे था 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. तो how many rows are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, rows are 5. Rows are 5. Fixed. See now columns. First row ma 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First row ma 5 columns. Second row ma 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 columns. 3 columns. 2, 1. What have you seen? Columns are decreasing. First row ma 5 column. Second row ma 4 column. Like that. Means columns are decreasing from top to bottom. How to write a such kind of a statement, such kind of program statement to display this output? Let us see now. CLS, you can write for loop, you can write while loop. For loop is little bit easy to write, so that we preferred the for loop. For I equal to what? 5 or 1 to 5. 1 to 5. Or j equal to, for j equal to 1 to I. No. 5 to I. 5 to I. And then stop. State minus 1. State minus 1. Print a statement. Print what? J. Semicolon. Next. Next J. Same thing. Print. Now. Next I. End. Finished. See the difference. See the difference. That time I have written 1 to 5, but inner for loop written 1 to I. Here I have written 5 to I. Let us see from the beginning. 1 to 5 means why 1 to 5? Because there are 5 records, 1 less than equal to 5. 1 less than equal to 5. Yes, condition is true. It comes in the body of outer for loop, inner for loop condition we check. J is equal to 5 to I. Then in a student, it started from 5. The 5 greater than equal to I. I to value is 1. I to value is 1. The 5 to 1 means 5 greater than equal to 1. Yes, condition is true. The yes is the condition true. It comes in the body of inner for loop. This print statement, then in a student, loop deja, condition is changed. Print statement executed, print J. The J value is 5. The 5 is printed. Semicolon in the same line, cursor is waiting. The same line, cursor is waiting. Next J. Of very dangerous. Very dangerous. Next J equal to J plus 1. Why na? Step minus 1, sir. It decreases the J by 1. So that J equal to J minus 1. The J value is 5. 5 minus 1 equal to 4. The value of J becomes 4 now. Now, student, it goes to check condition up. जे अब जी क्वाल फोर ले आ लियो फोर ग्रेटर देन वन यस कंडीशन इज ट्रू फिर ही आंसर इट कम्स इन द बॉडी ऑफ इनर फॉर लूप प्रिंट स्टेटमेंट एग्जीक्यूटेड प्रिंट जे तो जे के वैल्यू आप कती ले आ लियो फोर इट विल प्रिंट फोर कर्सर इज बिटवीन द सेम लाइन ध्यान दे लो नेक्स्ट से जे इक्वल टू जे मार जे इक्वल टू जे माइनस 1 तो 4 माइनस 1 इक्वल टू 3 अब जे के वैल्यू 3 ले आ लियो फिर ही कंडीशन चेक करना चाहते हम आती 3 ग्रेटर देन 1 यस कंडीशन इज ट्रू अगेन कम्स प्रिंट जे अब जे के वैल्यू 3 सो दैट इज प्रिंटेड like that it becomes 2 down again condition will change 2 greater than 1 yes condition is true again comes print j j equal to 2 here and above like that j minus 1 2 becomes 1 again student 1 equal to 1 yes condition is true then print statement execute ho jan print j j equal to 1 ho jan ab dhyan deno last time अब जे के वैल्यू कितनी आई था 0 कंडीशन में चाहिए 0 ग्रेटर देन 1 0 इक्वल टू 1 नो कंडीशन इज फॉल्स एंड व्हेन द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स आई टोल्ड यू दिस मच पार्ट इज नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड कम डाउन दिस प्रिंट स्टेटमेंट टू ब्रिंग द कर्सर इन नेक्स्ट रो नाउ स्टूडेंट नेक्स्ट आई जे को किस में ध्यान देना उस स्टेप माइनस 1 थियो सो दैट जे इक्वल टू जे माइनस 1 But in the case of I, step minus 1 is not there, so that it will be I equal to I plus 1. I plus I equal to I plus 1. The I equal to 1. The 1 plus 1 equal to 2. The value of J becomes 2 now. Goes to check condition up. I, that is 2. 2 less than 5. This condition is true, 2 less than 5. Again, it comes in the body of loop. अगेन इनर फॉर लूप स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 5 टू i कहां देखि शुरू हुन्छ फेरि यो 5 देखि शुरू हुन्छ 5 देखि शुरू हुन्छ 5 टू i i को वैल्यू कति छ 2 5 ग्रेटर देन 2 यस कंडीशन इज ट्रू यस मींस कम एंड प्रिंट j व्हेन j को वैल्यू कति छ 5 Like that, student. Next J. So J equal to J minus 1. J equal to J minus 1. So J equal to 5. So 5 minus 1 equal to 4. Again, condition is true. Print J. Prints 4. J minus 1. The 4 minus 1 equal to 3. Very condition J. Condition is true. Pujhi raha chalita. Ma fast kadi raha chu because same thing I'm going to repeat again and again. Same questions are there. 3 greater than 2 yes then print j next j j equal to j minus 1 the 3 minus 1 equal to 2 here yeah, I have 2 equal to 2 yes condition is true again comes print j when if j is 2 next j the 2 minus 1 equal to 1 1 greater than 2 no 1 equal to 2 no condition is false this was the statement is not executed Print statement executed to bring the cursor in third row. Next, I equal to I plus 1. I equal to I plus 1. The value of I is 2. The 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Your 3 comes to value. 3 becomes the value of I. Goes to check condition up. 3 less than 5. Yes, condition is true. Yes means and it comes in the body of outer for loop and theory ध्यान देना उस मेरे तेरी पूरा repeat कर दिया तू again it started from 5 5 greater than equal to I को बेल कर दिया 3 last time I'm explaining this program the 5 greater than 3 yes condition true the print j value of j is 5 you know very well j minus 1 the 5 becomes 4 yes condition is true it prints 4 5 4 becomes 3 yes condition is true it prints 3 3 becomes 2 condition is false not executed print statement bring the cursor next row like that when the value of I becomes 2 then here it prints 5 4 and at last it prints 5 when the value of this when the value of 2 thio 1 thio and now it becomes 0 sorry it becomes now next I equal to I plus 1 I equal to I plus 1 कर दियो ये 6 रियल सर 6 less than 5? No. 6 equal to 5. Conditions are false. In that case, outer for loop is not executed. From 4i to next i, no statement is executed. In the statement executed to stop and terminate the program execution. Such a way, students, all the series that I have given yesterday, and I have also given this question number 4 is also left. I am not going to make it. You try yourself. So many questions are based on series. All the problems you will try yourself by the help of nested for loop or by the help of nested while loop. You can solve it. Only you have to think the condition, how to write the condition of the looping statement. How to write the condition of the looping statement. Correct now? Clear? Now, our student, if you want one more meaningful program, I can do that. What is that? Suppose in every terminal examination, after every terminal examination, you are getting the mark sheet, report card, result sheet. How it is calculated? It is calculated by the help of program. How to write a such kind of program? Do you want? If yes, then write question. Write on. Question number 5. Write a cubistic program to take student roll number, comma, name and 5 subjects mark. 5 subjects marks. Full stop. Calculate total mark, comma, percentage and division for 40 students. For 40 students. Matlab 40 jana vidyarthi ko lagi. 40 jana vidyarthi ko lagi mark sheet banao. Ke liye ra student ko roll number lene, student ko name lene, aur har ek student ko lagi 5 subject ko mark lene. Matre 5 subject. 5 subject ko mark lene. Ke karne hawa to total mark calculate karne, percentage calculate karne, aur division calculate karne. 40 jana vidyarthi ko lagi. How to write a such kind of program? Let us see, a student. It is a meaningful program, and by the help of this program, a result sheet is calculated everywhere. In our school also, the mark sheet is calculated, the result sheet is calculated on the basis of the program that I am going to write today. Student. CLS, let first of all 40 students for i equal to 1 to 40, let sum equal to 0, let percentage equal to 0. Now input statement. Input give a student roll number. Second input statement. Input give student name. एन डलर ध्यान दिनुस यहाँ डलर छैन अब विद्यार्थी को रोल नम्बर पनि लिसके नेम पनि लिसके अब के छ त तर एउटा विद्यार्थी को एउटा रोल नम्बर एउटा नेम तर पाँच सब्जेक्ट को मार्क त्यसको लागि अर्को रूप लगाउनु पर्छ अगेन फर लूप फर j = 1 to 5 कतिवटा मार्क को छ पाँच सब्जेक्ट सो दैट 1 to 5 इनपुट स्टेटमेन्ट इनपुट give student mark suppose I am going to write suppose m that is mark here student we are going to find the sum of that mark let sum equal to sum plus what m after that next j sum you have calculated we have to calculate the percentage then let pr equal to percentage equal to suppose examination of the 500 mark sum divided by 5 simply it is also the kind of formula to calculate a percentage now we are going to calculate the division to calculate the division here student on the basis of percentage we are going to calculate the division here if percentage greater than equal to 40 then division equal to pass else division equal to fail end if now write on the result of students here I am writing a CLC statement again now result sheet print result result sheet of student again print a statement roll number equal to r print name equal to n dollar let that student print total mark equal to sum let that student print percentage equal to percentage equal to PR like that student division like that student division equal to here print division equal to DIV dollar now in a for loop is executed division we have calculated now next j now print next i now in next dhyan dinusta it is 90% meaningful program little bit correction we have to require because we have to display the output we have to keep the output in the memory in the disk of computer and later on we have to print it as per the requirement by maintaining the data file now start from that we have a 40 strings the for I equal to 1 to 40 correct that is 1 less than equal to 40 condition true sum equal to 0 percentage equal to 0 by the help of input statement, we are going to take a student roll number. Suppose roll number you have given 1. By the help of second input statement, give a student name. Suppose the student ko naam tha Ram. Roll number is 1. Student ko naam tha Ram. And roll number 1 ko lagi, we have a requirement to take a 5 subject mark. So that for j is equal to 1 to 5. Now 1 less than equal to 5. Yes, condition is true. Come in the body of loop. Input statement, give a student mark. First time it will display, give a student mark. Suppose you have given mark, that is 40. 40 becomes value of m. Suppose you have given math mark. 40 you have given, that has gone to the m. And next statement, sum equal to sum plus m. The sum to value 0 cha. The 0 plus 40 equal to 40. Next j equal to j plus 1, it becomes now 2. Condition true. Again comes, again input statement executed, give a student mark, or the second subject mark. Suppose you have given 45, that becomes the value of m. Sum equal to sum plus m. The sum ko value 40 cha, the m ko value 45 cha, that will be 85. Like that, the student, next j equal to j plus 1, 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Condition is true. Again, input statement, give a student mark. Suppose you have given third subject mark is 15. Come down, sum equal to sum plus n. The value of sum is 85 plus 15. Kati aunchan? 100. No. 100. Like that, next day, j equal to j plus 1, 3 plus 1 equal to 4. Ab chauthu subject ka mark ke liye hai. Condition true. Hari mark, you suppose 25 hi hai. The 100 plus 25, 125. Bujhi raha jaldi baat hota. Ab yo next day, the value of 5 hi hai. Again condition true. Last subject ko mark hamili raha chu. Panchu subject ko mark hamili raha chu. Again condition true. Give a student mark. Suppose you have given 35. The sum equal to sum plus m. The 125 plus 35, 0, 160. Total mark is calculated, that is 160. Ab dhyan dino. Next day, j equal to j plus 1. J ko value we are about 6. The 6 less than 5. No condition is false. जब कंडीशन फॉल्स था, यू नो दैट दिस मच स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड, मतलब हामीले पांच का सब्जेक्ट को मार्क लिएर टोटल कैलकुलेट गरी सकेको छु. यसको तल आउँछन् परसेंटेज कैलकुलेट गर्छ, सम डिवाइडेड बाई 5. द 160 डिवाइडेड बाई 5 कति आउँछन्? 32%. सपोज इट विल कैलकुलेट एट 32, दैट बिकम्स द वैल्यू ऑफ पीआर. अब ध्यान दिनुस यहाँ PR को वैल्यू 32 छ, त 32 हियर 32 ग्रेटर देन 40. नो कंडीशन ऑफ इफ स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स, नॉट एग्जीक्यूटेड. एल्स पार्ट इज एग्जीक्यूटेड, डिवीजन इक्वल टू फेल. व्हाट डिवीजन इट विल बी कैलकुलेटेड? इट इज कैलकुलेटेड फेल डिवीजन. एंड इफ टू क्लोज द बॉडी ऑफ इफ स्टेटमेंट. अब ध्यान दिनुस स्टूडेंट, अब CLS मतलब आउटपुट विंडो लाइक क्लीन करछ. A print statement executed, it will display result sheet of students. Here written roll number, it will print roll number equal to R. R ko value kaisa 1. Name equal to n dollar, that is Ram. Total mark equal to sum, that is 160. Chali ba uta 160. Total mark kati calculate kaya cha 160. And percentage equal to 32. Like that, division pani yaha calculate bhai ko cha. Division equal to DIB, that is fail. Next J statement यहाँ close हो देना बाबू, बेटा पूरा ध्यान दे. Next J statement यहाँ close हो देना. Next J statement यहीं close भी आजा. Next J यहाँ हम चल next I बोलते. Next I statement I equal to I plus 1, the value of I is 1, the 1 plus 1 equal to 2, it goes to check condition again up 2 less than 14. Yes, condition is true. अब ध्यान दिनो और सेकंड स्टूडेंट को लागी फेरी कंडीशन ट्रू भयो, फेरी सम को वैल्यू 0 भयो, फेरी परसेंटेज वाले दिन भर फिर यो सेकंड स्टूडेंट को रोल नंबर भंचन रोल नंबर दिने नेम दिने पांच छोटा सब्जेक्ट को मार्क दिने ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट इट विल कैलकुलेट द टोटल मार्क इट विल कैलकुलेट द परसेंटेज इट विल कैलकुलेट द डिवीजन एंड इट विल प्रिंट द मार्कशीट ऑफ सेकंड स्टूडेंट लाइक दैट स्टूडेंट मेक्स आई आई इक्वल टू आई प्लस वन टू प्लस वन इक्वल टू प्लस वन इक्वल टू थ्री थ्री लेस देन 40 यस फॉर द थर्ड स्टूडेंट Again, it will take a student roll number, a student name, a student's five subject mark. It will calculate a total mark. It will calculate a percentage. It will calculate a division, and it will print the mark sheet of a student in the output window that is monitored. Like that, a student on the basis of this program, mark sheet of a student is calculated. Meaningful result ko lagi database maintain karnu parcha and. 8 subject ko in the place of 5 subject mark we have to take a 8 subjects mark okay student the only little bit correction we have to do to make a 100% meaningful program to generate the mark sheet of students correct now today up to this much only next day I will discuss the next topic for class 10 thank you very much